crap. Huh?
Another one.
Not the big.
Now I'm just getting warmed up.
Relay is active.
Huh. Another one.
She wasn't ready.
What is going on, everybody? It is your boy, Nothing But Skills, and today I'm bringing you another division video. Today's build video is going to be focused on the Classified Nomad. I know in the past I brought you a build video, but I recently did a lot of changes to it, and I've been running this build this way for about a month now. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, but before we get into it, I just want to say thank you guys again for all the support. Remember, if you guys want to ever see me live, you need to head over to Twitch, drop a follow. It's free service. You can download the app free. Just head over to Twitch. I'll put a link in the description box below. And then across the screen right now, you will see my link. It's twitch.tv/nothingbutskillsgaming. So that's enough talking, guys. Let's get into the build. So the first thing you're going to notice is my primary firepower is 454,000. That's firearms at 8,000. My toughness is 426,000. That's stamina of 5,200. And then my skill power is 88,000. And that's electronics of 2,900. So what is a six-piece nomad? We'll talk about it really quick for a lot of you guys who might not know. And for the rest of you, we'll get right into the build right after that. So for set bonus 2, we get an additional 15% health. For set bonus 3, we get Nomad's Resolve. It grants a constant small amount of healing, allowing the user to regenerate all segments of health bar during combat. And then of course, set bonus 4 gives you Path of Nomad. When receiving fatal damage, you're instantly healed to full health. This can occur once every 4 minutes. So if you are about to die, what Nomads will do is going to give you a full bar of health, and then you have to wait 4 more minutes if you're only running a 4-piece. Now that does change with the 6-piece, and we'll get into that right now. Set bonus 5 gives me an additional 10% health on kill, and then it gives me an improved Nomad Resolve. So increasing the amount of healing from the Nomad Resolve, and the Nomad Resolve will now overheal. So when you're running around, it will look like you had just popped an overdose because you will have that full green bar above your health bar. Set bonus 6 is going to give me Nomad's Luck. This is 50% chance to have no cooldown for the Path of Nomad. You take 60% less damage for 10 seconds after Path of Nomad is triggered. So every time your Nomad procs, you get 60% less damage taken in for 10 seconds. So the way I'm running this build, on the chest, it's rolled firearms, it has exotic damage resilience, it has health, and has ammo capacity. For the mods, they're rolled stamina mods with critical hit chance. For the mask, it's rolled firearms, it has exotic damage resilience, and then it has minor attribute of burn resistance. And then for the mods, it has stamina mods with critical hit chance. For the knee pads, they're rolled stamina. The major attributes critical hit damage, the minor attributes are damage to elites, bleed resistance, and disorient resistance. Now if I had the perfect knee pads, I would like to have something like shock resistance, bleed resistance, burn resistance. I was only able to reroll my major attribute and my main stat. For the mods, I have stamina mods with critical hit chance, and then performance mod with 6% first aid self heal. For the holster, the major attribute I went with was critical hit chance, and the mods I'm running with are performance mod with 6% first aid self heal. For the gloves, they rolled firearms, they have critical hit damage, SMG damage, and critical hit chance. Now, if I was going to run an assault rifle, I would have assault rifle damage here instead of SMG damage. For the backpack, it's rolled firearms, the major attribute is critical hit damage, and the minor attribute is 17% bleed resistance. Now, you could have burn resistance on here. I tend to like having a little bit of bleed resistance on my build. It doesn't affect the damage that you take from Predator's Mark bleed, but it will reduce the amount of times it ticks on you. Someone's Predator Marks hits you for 5 ticks, you might only get hit for 4 ticks with having some type of bleed resistance. And that just really depends on how much bleed resistance you have stacked on your build. For the mods, I'm running stamina mods with critical hit chance, and then performance mod with first aid self heal. So if we get into the weapons, I'm running the house. It has 23% critical hit chance. It has 22.8k base damage. The talents I'm running are deadly. Critical hit damage is increased by 15%. It has responsive damage increased by 10% when closer than 10 meters to the target. It also has card counter. One half of the magazine does 20% increased damage. The half which deals increased damage flips after 15 seconds or when the magazine is empty. The way I have this modded is I'm running a pro red dot sight with critical hit damage, headshot damage, and critical hit chance. Now, if you wanted to stack a little bit more critical hit chance and a little bit less critical hit damage, you can switch it for a reflex sight scope that's going to give you an additional 4% critical hit chance, 14% less critical hit damage. So if you're okay with stacking more critical hit chance than critical hit damage, by all means, you can use that reflex sight. But I feel that having the pro red dot sight is more beneficial for me, since a lot of times someone on my team is going to run a pulse and it will max me out with my critical hit chance. For the muzzle, I'm running a Lauven break that has critical hit damage, headshot damage, and critical hit chance. For the small grip, I'm running critical hit damage, reload speed, and optimal range. And then for the extended magazine, I'm running magazine size, critical hit chance, and rate of fire. For my secondary, I'm running the Warlord. This has 24% enemy armor damage. It has 27,000 base damage. The talents I'm running are responsive. Damage is increased by 10% when closer than 10 meters to the target. Unforgiving missing health segments increase your damage. One missing segment plus 10%, two missing segments plus 25%. And then has the cool talent of Play Rough that only the Warlord has. Damage taken is reduced by 20% when firing. The damage is applied when you stop firing. The mods I have on this are Reflex Sight Scope with critical hit chance, critical hit damage, headshot damage. It has a loud vent break with 18% critical hit damage, 3% critical hit chance, and 6% headshot damage. It has a small grip with critical hit damage, reload speed, and stability. And then has extended magazine with magazine size, critical hit chance, and rate of fire. For my sidearm, I always recommend running some type of double barrel sawed-off shotgun. Like the one I'm currently running has determined on it in the bottom slot, so it's always going to be unlocked. Killing a target reduces all skill cooldowns by 7.5%. It also has predatory. Killing a target regenerates 35% health over 20 seconds, which is really good because if I drop a player on the ground, I can switch to my sawed-off, finish him off with a double barrel, determined will kick into effect, and then I'll get predatory active, which will give me 35% health over 20 seconds. And then I always like having responsive, and that way I can hit a little bit harder when the player is on the ground. I can finish him off a lot faster. So I like running responsive, predatory, and determined in my double barrel sawed off. So if we get into the skills, you're gonna see I usually run a booster shot, and with this build I am running a booster shot. The booster shot's gonna temporarily increase my damage and my damage resistance as soon as I pop it. This is gonna come back every 51 seconds, and my self heal is only gonna be around 48,000. I pair that up with an immune box, and this is great for dropping on the ground if someone drops a shock turret. I mainly use it as an extra heal, my main heal, because it's gonna heal me way more than my booster shot. This is gonna come back every 36 seconds, but this will help you against shock turrets, so you can leave it on the ground, fight the player, and worst case, if you need to explode it, you'll get that heal back. So for my talent, since I'm mostly running this in a group and PvP, I always have triage, heal an ally with the skill to reduce skill cooldowns by 15%. I run critical save, use medkits during low health to increase damage resistance by 20% for 10 seconds. I run combat medic, use medkits near allies to heal group members and proxies within 20 meters for 40%. And then of course I run strike back, reach low health to reduce active skill cooldowns by 20%. So if we go into the character, you're going to see my critical hit chance is 46%. Now if I was going to put a reflex sight scope on this house, I would get up to 50%, but since I'm running a pro red dot sight, it's at 46%. My critical hit damage is going to be at 130%, and then my headshot damage is 62%. I have 16% damage to elite, which I don't need for this build since this is a PvP build. Now I would like to have shock resistance instead of damage to elites on my knee pads, but I have that 16% on my knee pads. I have 25% health on kill. My max health is 283,000. My armor mitigation is maxed out at 33%. My exotic damage resilience is 22%. My bleed resistance is 50%. My burn resistance is 17%. My disorient resistance is 33%. And that pretty much wraps up this build, guys. That is how I recommend you guys running this build if you're running a nomad. I know a lot of guys are trying to run 9,000 firearms. I personally don't like 9,000 firearms. I feel like you're more of a glass cannon. The reason why you are able to run 8,000 firearms and a lot less stamina is because you have that overheal and then you have that extra life. So that's why if you know you have an extra life, you can face tank somebody. If it pops, most likely you will drop them before they have a chance to kill you again. For me, this is how I found the best way to run this build. I run 8,000 firearms, 5,000 stamina, and then I stack all critical hit chance and critical hit damage mods on this build. So if you guys still have any questions after watching this video, use the comment section down below. Remember, if you're new to my channel and this is the first time you're watching a video, hit that subscribe button. I just want to say thank you guys for all the support. Hit that thumbs up. But for now, guys, if you don't see me in Last Stand, if you don't see me in Skirmish, if you don't see me in the Dark Zone, it's only a matter of time. Nothing But Skills is out.